Yeah. Soon as I enter, you know who it is. This the representative from the east side of Atlanta. Let's go.
Hi, I'm Crystal Streets at Mercedes-Benz Fashion Week.
Hey, what's up? I'm Adrian Bailon.
Hi, this is Robert Birdie.
This is Anika Noni Rose.
What's up? This is Aubrey O'Day.
Lance Briggs.
Hi, I'm Cataluna.
Hi, I'm Cynthia Bailey from The Real Housewives of Atlanta.
Hi, this is David Bennett.
This is Jennifer Williams from VH1's Basketball Wives.
This is Nice, and I'm Ham from Jean Shirts. You're watching DopeFiles.com.
Hey, everybody. This is Jade. You're watching DopeFiles.com. Is that it? Dope Files?
Hey, guys. It's your girl, Janissa Bermudez, and you're watching DopeFiles.com. It's so dope.
What's up? It's Coco and Breezy, and you're watching DopeFiles.com.
What's up, everyone? You know Fashion Week is on its way, so we are starting to interview some designers and get some exclusive for you for DopeFiles.com. I am Latasha, and today I'm talking to the haute couture designer of Adrian Alicea.
Yes.
Did I say it right?
Yeah, Adrian Alicea.
Mm-hmm. You have to say it with like the accent and make it all, you know, nice. You know, I'm trying, guys. I'm trying.
You're doing a good job.
Thank you. I'm so excited. We're in your studio and we get to see some exclusive clothes of you and what you're going to display for Fashion Week. How are you feeling for your debut?
I feel good. You know, you always get the little nervous butterfly thing going on, but I'm good. You know, I've been working hard for the last 7 months on this collection, and it's all hands-on. I make it myself, so it's not involving, you know, a bunch of seamstresses, which is hard. And this collection was inspired by the Duchess of Devonshire, a little bit of Betty Page, Sherlock Holmes, and the world of animation. But I like hands-on. I like handling the fabrics and working with the models. That makes me all work with the trip.
Of course, it definitely is. Can I see some of the pieces that you're going to be showing for Fashion Week?
Okay.
Look at this, guys. This is couture right now. This is like an urban couture.
Yeah.
I like that.
I love the hood. I was inspired by beekeepers. Yeah, and the whole with the old school, like alien.
Mm-hmm.
So that's been one of my favorite moments, hands-on, making the actual garment and seeing it actually on the runway and say, wow, I did that. It's like, sometimes I can't even believe it. I'm like, I'm crazy.
Your dream is realized.
Yes.
Watching Dope Files, and we just finished viewing Adrian Alicea's runway collection. Yes. How you feeling?
I feel good. I feel relieved.
You feel relieved? All that pressure was on you, huh?
It was.
Pieces were breathtaking. When the finale dress came out, I had to stop for a second. Like, it was so beautiful. Talk to us about that finale dress.
The finale dress, wow. I mixed it up, you know, because I used the wools and then that beautiful, like, mesh ruffle. Mm-hmm. The mixture was really beautiful, and the model,
Nakor. She's with Red. She's just beautiful.
Fall is definitely approaching. We're going to be looking at your stuff for that season. So tell us, what is one of the strong pieces that you want us to like go out and get for fall?
Well, you got to have your hoods because it gets cold. So I made some like wonderful big old hoods that I think that every woman should like, you know, they like to just hide away or something.
I would love to hide away, and I'm bald, so I get really cold. And I want everyone to know that I got my Nico and Adrian gift bag.
Yes.
I mean,
I'm happy you got
it. I'm happy too. I have some sexy men's underwear here.
You wear them.
I definitely will. I'm going to sneak them under some jeans or something. I'm going to work them into my wardrobe. Yeah. Okay, we're still checking in for Adrian Alicea Runway Show, and I'm here with choreographer.
Yes.
Fame dancer Pony Dion. What's going on?
How you doing? You enjoyed yourself tonight?
I definitely enjoyed myself. Beautiful rose petals on the floor, the finale dress, jaw dropping.
Oh wow. The little girl.
The little girl.
And she was like walking, the hips was out. It was amazing. I really enjoyed myself.
She was good. She was good. What was your favorite piece on the runway?
It had to be, you know, the guy. He had this big cloaky kind of hood thing. I think a female had it also. It was that whole kind of denim look. And to go from underwear to like haute couture is like, wow. You know, and excellent. Everything was clean. Everything was cut right. It was amazing.
Well, they actually chose from our collection. We did this. This is our second season working with them. He's a genius.
Oh, is this from the shoe collection?
Yeah, this is one of the shoes you'll see going down the runway along with mine. This is our first season doing menswear, and Malan asked us if we would do the men for the show.
On the first page of our story, the future seemed so bright. Just gonna stand there and watch me burn. That's alright, because I like the way it hurts. Just gonna stand there and hear me cry. That's alright, because I love the way it lies.
Very emotional show.
What's making you so emotional right now?
Just the elements, the theatrical elements, the like, the concept. My friends were a part of it. They, you know, they had their sort of vowel element there. They did the whole thing. It was just beautiful. Really.
Tell us the story behind your beautiful collection. We know it's a lot of Asian inspiration.
A lot of Japanese inspiration this season. I grew up in Asia, so I like to kind of explore each country that I traveled through in my collection. So this was part Japan.
Did the dance mean anything, the dance that they performed?
Yeah, the dancing, in the opening number is one of my best friends, it's Ariana Grande, and the song is very symbolic to a lot of things that have been happening over the last 6 months of my life. So
What was the strong piece that you're using for fall for your collection?
If you noticed the shoulder, yeah, definitely on the women's shoulder, and then the really tailored men's suits.
What's up, it's Latasha. We're here at the Coco and Breezy presentation for Fashion Week, and we're here with the black light models. Kids got their hands painted, strobe lights is crazy in here. But I have the two new models of the Coco and Breezy new collection. What's your name?
Kamani.
Kamani.
Madison. Madison, you guys, you girls are the flyest little things walking in here with your hair and accessories. How you feeling?
Good.
You're feeling good? How you feeling?
Good.
When did you guys get hired to work with Coco and Breezy? When did you start working with them?
This lady, she knew Coco and Breezy, and she showed them our pictures, and they just wanted us.
They just wanted you because you're so pretty.
Yes.
Did you model before?
Yes.
Where?
When we was little, like 4 or 5.
Yeah, you were real little. You ladies a grown woman now, right? Yeah. No, not yet. Not yet. Can I see you with your glasses on?
Yes.
Go ahead, put your glasses on. Oh shoot! You look cool now, girl.
Thank you.
And tell me what you're wearing, baby.
The same thing: a black dress, a coat, and my black shirt.
Let me see. What you got on here? That's heavy?
No.
It's not? So what you girls gonna do now that you're famous little models?
I don't know.
You don't know? You gonna go to school and say, back up off me, I'm famous?
Yes.
I know, that's right. What you wanna say to your new fans?
Thank you for watching us. My name is Kamani.
My name is Madison.
Watching
dopefiles.com. I got Coco and Breezy right next to me. I'm a feature triplet. Okay, y'all need to know when y'all gonna do something cool like that. Cause I gotta get in with y'all. You know
all
what
right,
I'm saying?
Cool.
Okay. But talk to me about your presentation today. I got dope models, you got kids, and tell me everything that's going on right now.
We're so excited. We finally brought people on Earth to our world. This is our planet. We're giving you black lights, we're giving you strobe lights, we're giving you bubbles, we're giving you lots of neon colors. With me and Coco, we're very dark, and so we thought it would be really awesome to throw some neon colors for our accessories. We started off with eyewear, and now we're branching out to accessories, and now we also have a kids collection, so we can get all out to the kids as well. So yeah.
That's dope, and tell me what I can find on a C&B planet.
Well, on planet C&B, our last collection we brought you to year 2020, but this collection is called Wearable Art. So when we were going through our planet C&B in 2020, we found a new city called Wearable Art, which we found all these bracelets floating in the air through the gravity, and the colors is what made the light into the air. And so now the pieces were floating, we just put it on our arm, and just it was art that you wear. People on Earth call it bracelets, but we call them wearable art.
That's right, because we're not on Earth anymore. We got, why you got arm and hands though, Coco?
Because I was painting my models, and I thought it was cute, so I left it.
You know what? I like it because it's like a glove, but not really.
Wait, can I say one thing? I might start rocking orange hands more often. I think I look like amazing.
Like, you should, because forget nail polish, just paint your whole head. Like,
exactly.
Just start it. I'm down. But you guys also have a cool program out now. It's for the Stop Bullying campaign. What made you want to start that?
Yes. We're super excited for our Stop Bullying campaign. What made us want to start that was when we were younger, we got made fun of, we got called crazy names. And so we want to bring fashion, art, and just to express people, like, just let people live. Like, people, like, bullying is such a huge thing right now, and it's mostly going with, like, about people's appearances. And so we want, us being young entrepreneurs, we want to share our experience and our knowledge with people, our fellow young people. And that's another reason why we did a kids collection, is because we want to get the kids started at a young age about how to be creative and being their own artists.
Absolutely. And your presentation's amazing. So much fun right now.
We worked so hard on this presentation. We planned this whole thing by ourselves, got the sponsors by ourselves, the guest list together, the media, because usually we have other people who do it for us, but no one ever does it how we want it. And so we're doing the party, the event together, and we're also designing at the same time. So it was stress. Like, our vision of this is that you guys are in Planet C&B in these rooms, and then when you go to each installation, it's almost like it's an art piece. That's how the models have paint on their bodies, so it's like we painted an art piece. We made them into whatever, but it's just art that's moving, you know?
I'm gonna need some color. I'm only in black and white today, so y'all gotta paint me with some orange and some green.
I got you.
Wait, Coco gonna paint me.
I'll get one for one dot.
Okay, you got one arm. And Breezy, tell me what's going on for C&B for 2011. What else we got after this presentation?
2011, at this collection, at this presentation, we're gonna launch a new website. We're rebranding ourselves. I'm excited. We're gonna start up with the campaign. We're gonna expand. Yeah, we're gonna Coco and Breezy everybody out, but we're gonna expand our brand.
All the Dope Files people, look out for that Coco and Breezy for 2011. Orange hands, no nail polish.
Woo! I already said, this is Coco and Breezy, and you're watching dopefiles.com, right?
Yes.
Woo!
Okay, you gotta say that.
Yeah!
Okay. They scaring me. I gotta.
Okay. We do saying. So many interviews. No. Yeah.
Okay. So one more drop.
Wait. This is what we do. Okay. All right. So. What's up? It's Coco and Breezy, and you're watching DopeFiles.com.
Pow. Check out our website, CocoandBreezy.com.
Pow.
Be your own artist.
Yeah, be your own artist, you guys.
Put shit on me.